1987, my family got cable TV. I was in the second grade. I remember really getting into video games, pro wrestling, and baseball around that time. It was also in that year that I got my very first pack of baseball cards. They were produced by Topps. These were the ones with the wooden borders. They were supposed to look like a bat, but they always just seemed kind of rustic to me. This was also about the time sports card collecting became a craze. Before Pops or Beanie Babies, there was Topps and Upper Deck
and the rest.
Baseball cards were a get-rich-quick scheme for speculators, a big business, and a hobby. See, earlier in the century, baseball cards had originally been giveaways in tobacco tins, later sold in packs to baby boomers who collected and traded with their friends for fun. Nobody ever used the term mint condition or market value. Shit, these kids used to use them in their bike spokes to make a farty motorcycle sound. Cut to the late 80s, and the largest generation to ever walk the earth was beginning to experience nostalgia, and part of that was baseball cards. Turns out, a few of the old cards were still floating around, stuffed into shoeboxes under beds, in attics and basements, just waiting to be rediscovered. And when they were, they found Mickey Mantle, Ted Williams,
and the rest.
They also found that most of these slips of thin cardboard had been lost to time, and the ones that were left were now valuable. It was officially on. Baseball cards were still being produced, and many thought, if these cards from 30 years ago is worth a lot, if I save these new cards, in 30 years, I'm gonna be rich. You may laugh, but an entire industry popped up overnight. Card shops, giant rooms filled with glass cases displaying these now valuable collector's items. Hundreds would flock to card shows to buy, sell, and trade baseball, football, basketball, and even hockey cards. All with the hopes that one day they would sell their collection and get stupid rich. Well, as it turns out, when something is sold as a collectible, there's really no guarantee that it will increase in value over time, or at all. A few short years after the whole craze began, it faded into the background and disappeared. Card companies had exhausted all the gimmicks and stunts they could muster to keep the cash rolling in, but it was too late. The speculators and scalpers had priced the hobbyists and collectors out of the market, and people began to just lose interest and find other ways to occupy their time. And those cards you bought in 1987 and kept in mint condition? They aren't worth dick. Well, some of the cards may catch you a couple bucks here and there, but nothing like what they were going for at the peak. And certainly not what those cards of the early to mid-century still pull in. Those are evergreen. Honus Wagner's tobacco card still fetches a fuck ton of money. Not that you're gonna find one in a pack anytime soon. So it all comes down to this. It's time to get rid of your baseball cards. Just throw them out. You probably haven't gone through them in years. You probably don't even know what you have. I know what you're thinking. They're not worth nothing. Somebody would buy my collection. There's some good stuff in there. Is there though? I mean, you don't want it anymore, do you? But somebody would buy it. Oh yeah? Who's gonna buy it? A card shop? Which one? Are they still even around? The ones that are pivoted to tabletop or MTG a long time ago. Sure, you could take the time to piece out your collection, pick out the good cards, and try to sell them individually on eBay. But that could take a long time. A really long time. And you know what? Even if you do sell off all your valuable cards, it won't be worth the time you spent going through the boxes and albums full of old cards, checking out prices online, judging condition, and finally putting cards into hard protectors to ship to God knows where for essentially peanuts for hours of labor. When I sold my mother's house after she passed, I was faced with a dilemma. There was a fuck ton of stuff there that I had left behind years ago. I had lived away from home for years without this stuff and could barely remember even owning some of it. And in a corner of the closet in my old room, there it was. Boxes and albums, all packed full of baseball cards. thousands of baseball cards. I had a decision to make. Do I pack this mountain of cardboard into my car and take it home with me to someday do something with? But let's be honest, it was just gonna sit there too. And I would have to pack it up every time I moved afterward, just carrying it around the country like a cardboard albatross. What I did do was just say, fuck it. I'm never gonna go through all this shit just to make a few bucks, and I certainly don't feel like carrying it around. So I threw them out. Not just the commons, or the ones that were never worth anything. All of it. The rookie cards, the platinum cards, the holograms and sticker cards. And it felt good. It was gone. It was finally over. Because that collection was never about making money. Everything I got out of that collection had been exhausted the day I put it away for the last time. The collecting, the hunting, poring over the stats, the friendships I made in the hobby. That was what I got out of it, and I'm happy with that. So if you have a pile of old cardboard that seems like a chore you've been avoiding for 20 years, just get rid of it. You'll be happy you did.